Dear students, welcome to another video tutorial on data warehousing and data mining. This is lecture 2 and the topic of this lecture is database versus data warehouse. Okay, so this is a very important part. Okay, we will be able to understand what are the differences between database and what is data warehouse. Okay, and why data warehouse has been introduced. Okay. So in this tutorial, we will learn about what is database, what is a data warehouse, what is the uses of database, and what are the uses of data warehouse. Next, we will learn characteristics of database. After that, we will learn characteristics of data house. Okay. Next, we will discuss about the differences between database and data warehouse. Then we will discuss about applications of databases and also the applications of data warehousing. Okay? And after that, we will discuss about disadvantages of databases and data warehouses. Okay? So as you can see that we have designed the tutorial in such a way that you will get the full concept of database as well as data warehouse. And when you will learn about database and data warehouse side by side, you will also able to understand what are the differences between them. Okay. So before starting, I want to introduce myself. My name is Niladri Shekhar Pal. I am working as an assistant professor at Computer Science and Engineering Department at Greater Kolkata College of Engineering and Management. The college is under GIS Group Educational Initiative. And the college is situated at Baroiti. Okay, so let's start. Now, what is database? Okay, basically, a database is a collection of related data which represents some elements of the real world. It is designed to be built and populated with data for a specific task. It is also a building block of the data solution. Okay, so then what is database? A database is basically a collection of related data, okay, which represents some elements of the real world. It is designed in such a way that it is used to build and populated with data for a specific task. It is also a building block of our data solution. Okay. Next come, what is data warehouse? Data warehouse is an information system which basically stores the historical and commutative data from single or multiple resources. It is designed to analyze, report, integrate transaction data from different sources. Data warehouses uses the analysis and reporting process of an organization. It is also a single version of truth for the organization, for decision making and forecasting process. Okay, so data warehousing is an information system, okay, which stores historical and commutative data from single or multiple sources. It is designated to analyze, report, integrate transaction data from different sources. Data warehouses is the analysis and reporting process of an organization. It is also a single version of truth for the organization for decision making and forecasting processes. So we have understand what is database and data warehouse. So as we can see that database is basically a collection of related data that represents some elements of the real world, whereas the data warehouse is an information system that stores historical and commutative data from single or multiple resources. Next, database is designed to record data, whereas the data warehouse is designed to analyze data. In the next point, database is application-oriented collection of data, whereas data warehouse is the subject-oriented collection of data. Next one is database uses online transactional processing, whereas data warehouse uses online analytical processing. Okay. The next point, database tables and joins are complicated because they are normalized, whereas data warehouse tables are joins and are easy because they are denormalized. ER modeling techniques are used for designing database, whereas data modeling techniques are used for designing data warehouses. Okay. So this is the basically basic difference between database and data warehouse. So I am once again repeating the difference. That is, database is a collection of related data that represents some elements of the real world, whereas data warehouse is an information system that stores historical and commutative data from single or multiple sources. Database is designated to record data, whereas the data warehouse is designated to analyze data. Database is application-oriented collection of data, whereas data warehouse is the subject-oriented collection of data. Database uses online transactional processing, whereas data warehouse uses online analytical processing. Database tables and joins are complicated because they are normalized, whereas data warehouse tables and joins are easy because they are denormalized. ER modeling techniques are used for designing database, whereas data modeling techniques are used for designing data warehouse. Okay, so these are the basic differences between database and data warehouse. Next come, why we'll use database? We will use databases. Okay, the prime reasons for using database systems are, it offers the security of data and its access. A database offers a variety of techniques to store and retrieve data. Database acts as an efficient handler to balance the requirement of multiple applications using the same data. A DBMS offers integrity constraints to get a high level protection to prevent access to prohibited data. And the next, a database allows you us to access concurrent data in such a way that only a single user can access the same data at a time. So why we'll use database? Because it offers the security of data and its access. Next one is, a database offers a variety of techniques to store and retrieve data. Next, a database acts as an efficient handler to balance the requirement of multiple applications using the same data. A DBMS offers integrity constraints to get a high level of protection to prevent access to prohibited data. And the next one is, a database allows us to access concurrent data in such a way that only a single user can access the same data at a time. Now come, why we'll use data warehouse. So there are some important reasons for using data warehouses. So these are, data warehouse helps business users to access critical data from some sources all in one place. Okay. And next, it provides consistent information on various cross-functional activities. Next, it helps us to integrate many sources of data to reduce stress on the production system. Next, data warehouse helps us to reduce total turnaround time for analysis and reporting. Next one is data warehouse helps us users to access critical data from different sources in a single place. So it saves users time of retrieving data information from multiple sources. We can access data from the cloud easily. Data next is data warehouse allows us to store a large amount of historical data to analyze different periods and trends to make future predictions. Next, enhance the value of operational business applications and customer relationship management systems. It also separates analytics processing from transactional databases, improving the performance of both systems. Stakeholders and users may be overestimating the quality of data in the source systems. Data warehouse provides more accurate reports. Okay. So why will you data warehouse? Number one is data warehouse helps business users to access critical data from some resources all in one place. Second one is it provides consistent information on various cross-functional activities. The third one is it helps us to integrate many resources of data to reduce stress on the production system. Next one is it helps us to reduce total turnaround time for analysis and reporting. Next point is data warehouse helps users to access critical data from different sources in a single place. So it saves users time of retrieving data information from multiple users. We can also access data from the cloud easily. Data warehouse also allows us to store a large amount of historical data to analyze different periods and trends to make future predictions. It also enhances the value of operational business applications and customer relations management system. It also separates analytics processing from transactional databases, improving the performance of both the systems. Stakeholders and users may be overestimating the quality of data in the source systems. Data warehouse provides more accurate reports. Now we'll discuss about what are the characteristics of database. Number one, it offers security and removes redundancy. It also allows multiple views of the data. Database system follows the ACID complications like atomicity, consistency, isolation, and durability. It also allows insulation between programs and data. Sharing of data and multi-user transaction processing. Relational database support multi-user environment. Okay, so these are the characteristics of database. So what are the characteristics? I'm repeating once again. It offers security and removes redundancy. It allows multiple views of data. Database system follows the ACID complication like atomicity, consistency, isolation, and durability. It also allows isolation between programs and data, sharing of data and multi-user transaction processing. It also relational database supports multi-user environment. Okay. So these are the characteristics of database. Now we discuss about the characteristics of data warehouse. A data warehouse is subject oriented as it offers information related to theme instead of company's ongoing operations. The data also needs to be stored in the data warehouse in common and unanimously acceptable manner. Okay. The time horizon for the data warehouse is relatively extensive compared with other operational systems. A data warehouse is non-volatile, which means the previous data is not erased when the new information is entered into it. Okay, so a data warehouse is subject-oriented as it offers information related to the theme instead of company's ongoing operations. The data also needs to be stored in the data warehouse in common and anonymously acceptable manner. The time horizon for the data warehouse is relatively extensive compared with other operational systems. A data warehouse is non-volatile, which means the previous data is not erased when the new information is entered into it. Okay. Next, we will discuss what are the differences between database and data warehouse. Okay. So let's discuss it one by one. So the number one is the purpose. Okay. So in case of database, okay, it is designed to record. Okay, but in case of data warehouse, it is designed to analyze. Next point is processing method. The database uses the online transactional processing, whereas the data warehouse uses online analytical processing. Next point is uses. The database helps to perform fundamental operations for our business, whereas data warehouse allows us to analyze our business. Next point is tables and joins. Tables and joins of a database are complex as they are normalized, whereas table and joins are simple in a data warehouse because they are denormalized. Next point is orientation. It is an application oriented collection of data. Okay. Whereas in case of data warehouse, it is a subject oriented collection of data. Next point is availability. Okay. So data is available. In case of database is available real time. Okay. Whereas in case of data warehouse, data is refreshed from source system as and when needed. Okay. So besides this, other points are like storage limit. So in case of database, generally limited to a single application, whereas in case of data warehouse, it stores data from any number of applications. Okay. Next point is technique. Basically, in case of database, it captures data, whereas in case of data warehouse, it analyzes data. Okay. Next point is data type. In case of database, data stored in the database is up to date, whereas in case of data warehouse, current and historical data is stored in data warehouse, which is may not be up to date. Next point is storage of data. Okay. So in case of database, flat relational approach method is used for data storage. In case of data warehouse, it uses dimensional and normalized approach for the data structure. Okay. Next point is query type. Okay. Basically, in case of database, simple transaction queries are used. Whereas in case of data warehouse, complex queries are used for analysis purpose. Next point is data summary. In case of database, detailed data is stored in a database, whereas in case of data warehouse, it stores highly summarized data. Okay. Now, next we will discuss about the applications of database and data warehouse. Okay. So these are the applications of database. Okay. So database are used in banking sector. In banking sector, it used in the bank for customer information, account related, okay, payments, deposits, loans, credit cards, etc. In airlines, it uses space for reservation and schedule information. In universities, it is used to store information, course registration, colleges, and results. In case of telecommunication, it helps to store call records, monthly bills, balance, maintenance, etc. In finance sectors, it helps us to store information related stock, sales and purchases of stocks and bonds. Okay. In sales and production, it is used for storing customer, product and sales details. And in manufacturing sector, it is used for the data management of the supply chain and for tracking production of items. Okay. Inventory status. In case of HR management, detail about employee salaries, reduction, generation of paychecks, etc. are the applications of database. Okay. Next, we will discuss about what are the applications of data warehouse. In the airline sector, it is used for airline system management operations like crew management, analysis of route, frequent flyer program, discount schemes for passengers, etc. In banking sector, it is used in the banking sector to manage the resources available on the desk effectively. In case of healthcare sector, data warehouse used to strategize and predict outcomes, create patient treatment reports, etc. Advanced machine learning, big data enable where data warehouse system can predict ailments. Okay. In case of insurance sectors, data warehouse is widely used to analyze data patterns, customer trend, and to track market movement quickly. In retail, it helps us to track items, identity the buying pattern of the customer, promotions, and also used for determining pricing policy. In case of telecommunication sector, data warehouse used for product promotions, sales decisions, and to make distribution decisions. Okay. So these are the uses of database and data warehouse. Okay. Now we'll discuss about the disadvantages of database and data warehouse. So what are the disadvantages of database? Number one, cost of hardware and software of an implementing database system is high, which can basically increase the budget of our organization. Many DBMS systems are often complex systems. Okay, so the training for users to use the DBMS is required. Next one is DBMS cannot perform sophisticated calculations. Issues regarding compatibility with the systems which is already in place. Data owners may lose control over their data, raising security, ownership, and privacy issues. Okay, so these are the disadvantages of databases. So what are the disadvantages? Cost of hardware and software of an implementing database system is high, which can increase the budget of our organization. Many DBMS systems are often complex systems, so the training for the users to use the DBMS is required. DBMS cannot perform sophisticated calculations. Next one is issues regarding compatibility with the system which is already in place. Data owners may lose control over their data, raising security, ownership, and privacy issues. Now come to the disadvantages of data warehouse. Adding new data sources takes time and it is associated with high cost. Next point is sometimes problem associated with the data warehouse may be undetected for many years. Okay. The next point is data warehouses are high maintenance systems. Extracting, loading and cleaning data could be time consuming. The data warehouse may look simple, but actually it is too complicated for the average users. We need to provide training to end users who end up not using the data mining and data warehouse. Despite best effort at project management, the scope of data warehousing will also analyze increase. Okay, so what are the disadvantages? At number one is adding new data sources takes time and it is associated with high cost. Next one is sometimes problems associated with the data warehouse may be undetected for many years. Next one is data warehouse are high maintenance system. Extracting, loading and cleaning data could be time consuming. The next point is the data warehouse may look simple, but actually it is too complicated for the average users. We need to provide training to end users who end up not using the data mining and warehouse. Next, despite best efforts at project management, the scope of data warehousing will always increase. So to sum up, we can say that the database helps to perform the fundamental operations of business, while the data warehouse helps us to analyze our business. Okay. So this is all about database and data warehouses. Okay. So to sum up, we can say that the database basically helps to perform the fundamental operation of business, while the data warehouse helps us to analyze our business. We have to choose either one of them based on our business goals. Okay. So students, this is all about database and data warehouses. Hope you have understood. If you have any doubt, any query, you can write on the comment section. If you like my videos, you can subscribe to my channel, or you can visit www.facebook.com/digitalclassroomniladripal and like my Facebook page. So students, thank you for now. See you on the next video tutorial.